once more and once more only, because I am getting ferocious, okay? Ferocious. Okay. An accent. I haven't been to America. But yeah, I'm losing concentration. Instagram baddie inspired makeup look. I really did try with this look, I'm not even gonna lie. Like, I did my research and I realized that it's a lot of pink, so I'm not really a pink fan, but you know, sacrifice is what they call it. So if you like this look, keep watching. If not, just don't give me a thumbs down, because no, why am I even promoting that? Wait, if you like this look, keep watching. If not, just throw some suggestions in the comments and I'll be sure to try and recreate them, because I'm just a new starter. Go easy on me. But thank you for watching anyway. Thank you. Bye.
Just make sure you rub this all over your face, as it does give you a nice silicone base. Okay, so here I'm just going in with my LA Girl Pro Conceal in the orange shade over my burn marks that I got from over scrubbing my face using my electric exfoliating machine. So I'm just going everywhere where I feel like it's dark, which I would want to be the same tone as the rest of my face. As you probably have noticed, I'm always mixing my Black Opal foundations together, just because I don't feel like one of them is basically too dark and the other one is too light, so sometimes you just gotta DIY it. So the reason why I always go in with the Sleek Face Contour Kit in dark, just to contour colour it as an eyeshadow transition shade, is because it's basically the kind of nicest shade that I've found to use as my transition at the moment, and it is kind of multi-purpose as well, so it's kind of a two for one buy, which is always great. Thank you. you can see, without going in with the brush and blending it down a bit, it would have been very harsh, and we ain't really going for that 90s eyeshadow look. I just love using eyebrow tweezers just because it kind of lets you get into the nooks and crannies of the eye, so it does let you place the eyelash a little bit closer than using your fingers, so it is really helpful. I'm a really big lover of the Black Opal foundations just because they are nice and thick and they kind of do have the perfect consistency, which I like, but sometimes you have to be very careful not to put too much on because they do get a bit cakey easily.